If you want to know who we are, we are citizens of Japan.
Welcome to a concert of Gilbert and Sullivan. We are the Durham Savoyards. We are a nonprofit theatrical company based in Durham, North Carolina. We do exclusively Gilbert and Sullivan shows. We've been around for over 40 years now. We're very excited to be performing for you guys today. The way that our organization works is we're not like a year-round theater company where we do a whole season kind of like Playmakers or Raleigh Little Theater. We devote a hefty part of our year to one production. There you go. There's the rain. There's the rain. Saw it when we were driving over. We devote the better part of a year to one production of Gilbert and Sullivan performed at the historic Caroline Theater in Durham. Now, show of hands, how many of you have seen one of our productions? Have you all been? Great, wonderful. So they are just as good and production value high as Playmakers, I would like to say, right? Right? I would like to think so. This past year, we did the Mikado. The year before, we did a lesser-known Gilbert and Sullivan piece called Rudigore. And then the year before that, we did an even more obscure piece. Now, raise your hand if you've heard of this, The Grand Duke. How many of you have heard of The Grand Duke? Right. Yeah, not as many people. And that's okay. And it's okay. But you missed a good one. This year, we're doing a show called Patience, which is a take on Oscar Wilde. Being a music person, I never said who I was. I'm Jackson Cooper. I'm the music director of the Durham Savoyards. Nice to see you. Patience is wonderful because it is a take on Mozart and light music, Vivaldi, Mozart, Gluck even, he makes fun of in some certain things. So I just want to take a moment first and foremost to say thank you to the Cedars for having us here, and thank you all for coming out on this now dreary day. I'm going to talk a little bit about what you're going to hear in between, not all of the songs, but just a few of the songs. So the first chunk of songs you're going to hear two songs from a piece that they wrote called Iolanthe, which talks about the battle between fairies and peers who were members of court in British Parliament. Then after that, you'll hear two songs from Pirates of Penzance, and then we'll end with a song of Mikado. Now, the interesting thing about this group of songs is that Gilbert and Sullivan wrote what are called persuasive love songs. Nearly every song in a Gilbert and Sullivan operetta is a love song. It either is, I love you, you love me, I love me, we love you, and I love I. This is a little odd, seeing as opera with Wagner and Mozart and such, there was always a formula to it, but you never got love songs like that. It was always something to move the plot ahead. And yet, love songs always were seen in opera and operettas as sort of holding the plot back. But here, Gilbert and Sullivan actually found a way to have the best of both worlds. So this next block of songs you'll hear is all about the stubbornness of people when they don't get their way in telling the other person that they love them or that they love themselves. So enjoy the stubborn side of Gilbert and Sullivan.
Embodiment of everything that's excellent. It has no kind of form of law, and I, the Lord, embody the law. The constitutional guardian, I, a pretty young mortal chancellor, I, all very agreeable girls, and none are over the age of 41. Occupation for a rather susceptible chancellor.
A pleasant occupation for a rather susceptible chancellor.
But though the compliment implied inflates me with legitimate pride, it nevertheless can't be denied that it has its inconvenient side. In love with one of my wards, which rather tries my patience more. I'm such a susceptible chancellor.
Which rather tries his patience more. He's such a susceptible chancellor.
And everyone who'd marry a ward must come to me for my accord. In my court, I sit all day, giving agreeable girls away. With one for him, and one for he, and one for you, and one for me, and one for thou, and one for me. Never, never a one for me. Which is exasperating for a highly susceptible chancellor.
Which is Scaling rock and rugged passes like a hardy little
sea drunk, killed him in a state of fire. Frank told him, old friend, I bear my big right arm. I seized him by his little pigtail, and on his knees fell in. And he squirmed and struggled and gurgled and gobbled, my true words never spared. Never shall I forget for the strait that swept me in. When from the sheath I drew my ship, I drew my stinker
sail.
So Gilbert and Sullivan songs can be drawn into two categories, men and women. The women have the better end of the stick. I know a lot of sopranos I've worked with have always said, oh, Gilbert and Sullivan is so great. But never have I heard a male soloist say, you know what has good solos? Gilbert and Sullivan. Reason being, and this is actually very intentional, I learned this the other day, is that Sullivan felt that women were very much the victims in operas. They always just had one big aria, and that was it. So they wanted to amend that, and they were very ahead of their time in terms of doing very strong female characters. The men were always made fun of in a lot of all of Gilbert and Sullivan. I'll just go out on a limb and say that, all of it. Mostly because they all traveled in packs or herds. They were policemen. They were pirates. They were peers. They were, you know, the Duke's attendants, all of that. And they were always the butt of all the jokes, which actually went against a lot of opera and operatic tropes at the time. At the time, women were the ones who were to fawn over the men, whereas in Gilbert and Sullivan, the men were the ones who were fawning over the women. And the women made it very hard for the men to fall in love with them. In fact, so hard, it takes about 2 hours for them to fall in love. And then it's all resolved in a 2-minute scene at the end. So as progressive as they were, this wonderful team, they still had to succumb to the times. Everyone still had to see in the final scene the woman going, "Yeah, I was wrong. I love you, and I've loved you the whole time." Rudigore is a great example of that. Rudigore spends 2.5 hours of the woman saying no to the man, and then finally in the last one, she says, "You know, I've been wrong the whole time. You know, who am I but a poor, poor young maiden?" So we'll forgive him a little bit. Musically, men in Gilbert and Sullivan were all about rhythm. And a lot of the men's songs were marching songs that made fun of Navy or regiments. And they were also patter songs. Men got a lot of the patter songs. I just ascertained that that is because there's so much that men talk too much, as I am now, that Sullivan had to put that into music. But really what they wanted was to reflect on the absurdity of power and how that affected men, where Shakespeare turned that into tragedy, sometimes comedy. Gilbert and Sullivan turned it into total satire. So they were early satirists for their time. They were the Saturday Night Lives of their time. Female songs resembled arias and yet continued to hold that powerful and strong female persona behind them. Very rarely in a Sullivan song does the woman fall victim in her aria. She is either working through her own troubles or she is ascertaining a decision that she is making about her well-being, her life, and sometimes, her love. Sullivan got this from his love of Verdi, Mozart, and Wagner. And the next group of songs, we'll be hearing a lot of the influences from these classical composers, not just in the lyrics of W.S. Gilbert, but in the music of Sullivan. So we'll hear something from Rudigore, a men and women duet, called Welcome Gentry, which is a parody of a Wagner, the six-hour Wagner opera, Der Meistersinger von Nuremberg. How many of you have seen that? I've seen it. I've seen it twice, actually. Yeah, I don't have any time on my hands, apparently. So, Poor Wandering One from Pirates of Penzance is a take on the Act Three aria in Marriage of Figaro, Mozart's Marriage of Figaro. And Merry Maiden from Gondoliers is another Marriage of Figaro parody. And then the final, When the Foeman Bears His Steel from Pirates, is yet another Wagner take, except a little lighter. Wagner was very famous for herds of people, groups of people, like a Meistersinger, a whole town, and the men being comical and buffoonish. And so you'll hear that in the final song. So enjoy this next couple of songs. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we've reached the near end of our program, and there will be a quiz afterwards, so please stick around for that afterwards. There's not much to say about the last few songs, except that they're from, two of them are from the Mikado, two are from Patience, which, as I said, is our upcoming production in April. Is that right? April? I should know this. April 2020 at the Caroline Theater. Once tickets go on sale, definitely get them, because we only do it for one weekend only, whereas like Playmakers and other theaters do multiple weekends. We work, by the way, everyone in this organization, with the exception of the director, the music director, and the accompanists, are all volunteers. So we have about 60 to 80 people who work on a show every season. Many of them are not only in the show in roles or in choruses, but they also help out building sets, doing costumes and such. And so, you know, I encourage you all to take a look at our website and check us out. And if you are interested in volunteering or perhaps helping to support us in whatever way is possible, I hope that you consider that going forward. If just to buy a ticket doesn't really cover the cost of our production, and so we do rely on donations in kind, financial, again, volunteer hours and such, so please consider us next time you give your annual gift. Now, I really like these last few songs, mostly because they really do embody what is so beautiful about Gilbert and Sullivan's collaboration, where very rarely, I think only, you know, Rodgers and Hammerstein, I think, are the only exception of a lyricist and a composer coming together and magic is created. Mozart once said about the end of Act One of Magic Flute that he had, when he was writing it, he had 1 foot on the earth and 1 foot in heaven. And so I always like to think, you know, when I hear these songs, and I hope you feel the same way, that Gilbert and Sullivan had that for sure. I mean, it's amazing that this music can sound so beautiful and fresh, and this was written, you know, a century ago, nearly. I mean, it's insane how modern and beautiful it sounds. So thank you guys so much again, and enjoy the last part of our program.
From the Congo and the Niger, and especially when lashing at the snake.
The volcanoes have split the lettuce green, and earthquakes only terrify the ducks. But to him, the scientific, there is nothing that's terrific in the falling of a flight of thunderbolts.
Yes, in spite of all my weakness, if I have a little weakness, it's a passion for a flight of thunderbolts. Yes, it's so tinny down tinny, it's evident, very artisan one. Away we go, and verily, very tardily, tinny till day is done. There's beauty in extreme old age. Do you fancy you are elderly enough? Information I'm requesting on a subject interesting is a maiden all the better when she's tough.
True, of this quite dominion, it's the general opinion that she'll also go get along if she's tough.
Are you old enough to marry, do you think? Won't you wait till you're 80 in the shade? There's a fascination frantic in her room that for men who you think you are sufficiently decayed.
To the matter that you mention, I have given some attention, and I think I am sufficiently decayed.
If that is so said, daddy down daddy, it's evident, very hard to someone. Away we go, and marry, never go tardily, take it till day is done. If that is so said, daddy down daddy, it's evident, very hard to someone. Away we go, and marry, never go tardily, take it till day is done.
a shake of his poor little head, he replied, "Oh, willow, tit willow, willow." He slapped at his chest as he sat on that bough, singing, "Willow, tit willow, tit willow." And a cold perspiration bespangled his brow. Oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow. He sobbed and he sighed, and a gurgle he gave. Then he plunged himself into the billowy wave. And an echo rose from the suicide's grave. Oh, willow.
So after every song and run-through of our shows, we always do the Durham Savoyards anthem, which is Hail Poetry from Pirates of Penzance. If you know it, feel free to sing along, but here's Hail Poetry. And then after that, we are good for the afternoon. So thank you guys so much again for having us. We hope to come back, and we hope to see you at Patience. If you are interested in learning more about us, again, visit our website. But also, if you don't feel like volunteering, you know, buying a ticket is great. That's wonderful. But we would love to see you in December when we do a community sing-through of Patience. No prior singing experiences required. Don't worry. Anyone can come. And that'll be downstairs in the Durham Arts Council. So sign up on our email list to find out when that is. Okay? Thank you guys so much again.
Yes.